Okay, so we are team number 4 or 3, something. And we're going to be talking about Virgin Americas. We have studied a lot of crucial points that determine where the poverty is more common in the population of America. I'm going to talk about North America. The two biggest countries of North America, United States of America, and Canada, are countries associated with prosperity rather than need. Both are major donors of aid to poor countries. This means that North America and Canada don't have this problem as often as other places in America do, but still, the United States holds a high rate of poverty and homeless people in their own country. We also know that poverty rates in the United States of America are higher for minorities than Hispanic whites, which means that there's a lot of segregation and marginalization from them, which also expresses a lack of multicultural spirit. And this also affects them as a country reputation. Also, we know that Canadian Research Institute has reported that almost half of Indigenous people leave some reserves get affected by poverty. This means that people in the U.S. and in Canada don't support Indigenous people as we do. For example, Mexico has big social support programs for Native people, and the U.S. doesn't. Also, we know that Mexico has high rates of poverty due to low salary and other factors such as unemployment, dependence to other countries, and some other stuff. Now, we're going to be talking about Central America.
Well, even though Mexico has a great variety of crops, the main crop is maize, and it has been the main source of food security and income for most farmers in many generations. In most Central American countries, income from traditional exports such as agricultural products and textiles is concentrated in the hands of relatively few people. But not many dedicated to agriculture and textiles, so that's why it just few people produce these kind of things. In large scales, those people are landowners and entrepreneurs. Three out of every four rural poor people cannot satisfy their basic nutritional needs. That's because even though they have farms and everything, the price may vary, and they cannot have all the crops by for themselves. And other thing is natural disasters have aggravated poverty in the region, particularly in Honduras and Nicaragua.
Okay, so here we can appreciate how people get in trouble by trying to survive and coexist within their own society, and how the capitalist system is destroying people who didn't got enough opportunities like a century ago and stuff. That fund should be more supported with people who
work in these conditions.
Yes, so me pueden poner la de okay, so now our partner Alejandro Villarreal, we Ricardo will be talking about other stuff.
Okay, so I'm going to talk about Mexico and their poverty problem. So in Mexico, over 40 million people live in poverty, which is about 40% of their population. And then from that 40 million, 15 million are living in extreme poverty. So they receive less than $1.25 per day. Even though Mexico is a pretty rich country, they have lots of oil, and they are in the 13th position in the world's best economies. Why almost half of its population is poor? That's because Mexico hasn't been giving enough resources, distributing them to other populations, and it has maintained inequalities inherited from the colonial times. And then Cuba, a strange case. Cuba is a strange case because even though they have lots of money and poor people, they can be considered poor. Why? Because in better terms, they are very equal and they have very nice services for their population. But since 2008, in the economic crisis, they have been affected, and they have been losing money both to the state and the population, so their economy is in risk. Thank you.
Okay, now I will talk about poverty in South America. Hi, Bernardo. Do you want to join our podcast?
Yay, we got a special guest. So,
say something, Bernardo.
Hello, people. I'm Mr. Allen. Hello.
Hi.
How are you? A question, how are you going to see like the 4 or 5 teams at the same time? Or what would you do about it?
It's another case of poverty. Another time.
Well,
okay. So I'm gonna talk about poverty in South America. In the rural areas, poor people also face the consequences of geographic isolation and limited public investment in education, healthcare, and other things. Rural poverty in the south. The south part of America is the deepest among indigenous people such as the Mapuches in southern Chile and other ethnic groups in Argentina. For the recent economic crisis that led to increasing poverty in many urban and rural areas. There are top five poorest countries in America, and that is firstly Haiti, and then on second place is Nicaragua. Third place is Guyana. Fourth place is Bolivia, and fifth place is Honduras. Some facts about poverty in Latin America is that 1 in 5 Latin Americans live in chronic poverty conditions. 130 million out of 500 million live in poverty. Most Latin American countries are in poverty, so we really need to do something about it. So now my friend Monroy will say his part.
So now we've got 11 facts about education and poverty in America. So according to the U.S. in 2011, a family of 4 people earns less than $33,000 a year. And more than 3 million children are growing up in poverty in one low-income community. There was only one book for every 300 children, which is very bad because the books for every children should be more than the amount of children there are. And in 2011, nearly 46.2 million people were living in poverty. And children living in poverty have a high rate of leaving school because they need to work, like, to provide money for their families. And dropout rates of 26 to 20 years old, 24 years old students who come from low-income families are 7 times more likely to drop out than those families with higher incomes. And a higher percentage of young adults with a high school diploma live in poverty compared to the 24% of young people who finish high school. 40%. Please join the live. We'll play the song when we finish. And 40% of children in poverty are prepared for primary schooling. Children that live below the poverty line are 1.3 times more likely to have developed the taste or learning disabilities than those who don't live in poverty. Okay, thank you. By the end of the fourth grade, African American, Hispanic, and low income students are already 2 years behind grade level. By the time they reach the 12th grade, they are 4 years behind, which is a big problem because people born in poverty do not get the education they need to live out of this poverty. And, well, thank you. This is all from our transmission. We will put the requested songs on the program. So, enjoy. Okay, so let's start with the first song. It's called Four Babies from Maluma, a great album, a great song for great people. Enjoy.
Well, that's all that we could say.
Thank you.